I hope to take attendance later as we go along. So three of your friends are helping me take attendance, those who are here. You should have your debrief notes. Debrief notes is this notes that I've prepared. And you should also have question paper and answer script. And I really want you to, for the meanwhile, just pay attention, please. Okay, now we want to learn where we went wrong for the 209 history O-level SBQ. And one of the things I always tell students is this. After a session like this, you go back home, you analyze your mistakes, and maybe over the weekend, you just take out the question paper, and you try to do the corrections. Okay, and try to get full marks. Okay, just be seated. Go right there. Okay. Make sure each table, three people are seated. It's okay, just do it. There's a Rizwan, Nuruda, there's an empty table there. Okay, can I have permission to continue again for the fifth time? Right. Now, one of the first things that I always encourage you to do is whenever you do a SBQ for history elective, is always to take note of the timeline, right? And in this SBQ, there are a few timelines. Okay? There are a few timelines. So these are all the very important timelines. I've written them down for you. So when we do SBQ, it's very important to know the timeline, because timeline makes a lot of difference, especially a source is before, during, or after. And one of the very important timeline is this date, 25th of June 1950. This is a very important date for you to know, because some of the sources here is on the 27th of June. Some is on the 30th of June. Some is before it. So you have to know when the timeline is. Yeah. Sudha. Thank you. So it's important to know, when these things happen. And this is another important date. The day after North Korean troops cross the 38th parallel, the United Nations decides to aid South Korea. Now, in this source that you're doing, there's a lot of talk about US role. Is the US making use of the UN to spread its power? Or is the US not making use of the UN to spread its power? That's something that you have to think through based on the source that's given to you. And these are some events, some of it you know, some of it you might not know. Okay, another very important event is when MacArthur lands at Incheon. How many months? 3 months away. And what is interesting is this. If you look at your notes, on the 3rd of October, China actually informed the US. Right? If US were to cross the Yalu River, they would attack the US. But what is interesting is that the US didn't take China seriously. Because don't forget, a couple of months before this, November 1949, China became communist. So the US felt that China is a new country. It has a lot of local problems. It will not fight the US. So they didn't take the China threat seriously. I just want to share that information with you. So when MacArthur really crossed the Yalu River, 300 Chinese troops started to attack UN forces. Then you have December 1950, UN forces retreat. MacArthur challenged Truman, and then armistice was signed 1953. So this is a timeline. I suggest this for all the other SBQ that you are doing, whether it's Stalin, whether it's the rise of Hitler, and later Cuban Missile Crisis, you need to have a timeline like this, a one-page handout telling you the timeline to help you. So whenever you do SBQ, okay, you'll have a timeline for history. Okay, after a while, you don't need the timeline, you memorize all the dates already. Because Hitler also has certain important dates. Like for example, if I were to ask you, when did Hitler become Chancellor? When was the Enabling Act? When was the Night of the Long Knives? When was the brown shirt uprising, Spartacus uprising, and all those kind of things? When? Yeah. When did he challenge Hindenburg? Or when did Hindenburg die? When was the Reichstag fire? All of these have to be by your fingertips. I see people shaking their head. Now maybe not very clear, but never mind. Come prelim exam, all of these have to be by your fingertips. And soon, we will start back after you finish your DNT, craft and tech, FNN projects, your artifact, you will have memory cleaning in term 3. Okay, so I just want to share that with you. Don't worry. As we go along, I will tell you more info about when it's coming. But I want you to understand that the dates are really important for history students. Okay? Alright. So next, this question.
Alright. Study source A.
Okay, study source A. What is the message of this cartoon? Explain your answer using details of the source and your knowledge. Okay, it's very, very important that whenever I go through, you look at your own answer. You look at your own answer and you make notes to yourself. And I was telling the class earlier that this weekend, take it onto you as a form of correction. Just take the question paper and do it again and try to get full marks. Now, this question is very interesting. If you were to circle this question, what details will you circle? I think I've told you in class. One of the things that we will circle is Truman holding hands with the United Nations lady, right? Another one is the look on Truman's face and the UN's look. What is their look? Their look is a very what?
Determined.
Very purposeful look. And there's another thing about the UN. She's portrayed as a lady. Very interesting. One of you noticed that she's actually a very muscular lady. Notice not? Right, her hands. One hand, she can hold a machine gun. Just so you know, this type of machine gun with this carbine magazine, right, is a gangster-style machine gun. Gangsters in the US, it's called a Tommy gun. T-O-M-M-Y, is used by gangsters. Very interesting. Never mind if you do not know that, but it's a machine gun. Jen E, one more time you talk, I'm going to change your seat. And Gerald. Vinching, finish talking. Oh, okay. Yeah, all right. Okay, I know you make your time to come here. I want to make it purposeful. And I really want to end latest at 7:30. By 7:15, we will end. We'll do a short revision. Okay, see how much of this you all remember. All right, then by 7:30, we should done. All right, that's what I want to do. I want to respect the time that everybody... It's great that everyone is here. I know some of my friends cannot make it, but never mind. Those who are here, let's make it meaningful. And hopefully after this, you can also continue studying for your other papers as well. Okay, what are the other things that you will circle? You will circle the tombstone, right? And the message on the tombstone that the League of Nations died. Lack of exercise. Now let's go back to the League of Nations topic. Why do you think they put a League of Nations in a tombstone to show that it's lack of exercise? What events that the League of Nations failed? Abyssinia. Okay, what was the year? It's very important. League of Nations died, Austin. Very important that United Nations is a replacement of the League of Nations. Okay? Do you know if you go to the United Nations headquarters, in where is the United Nations headquarters? No, it's not UK, it's in New York. If you enter the doorway, you know there's a big message. You know what it says? We, the people of the world, alright, twice in our generation have experienced the scourge of war. Create this organization to prevent another war from happening, something like that. So, what I'm trying to say is that the United Nations was set up to prevent war from happening, basically World War III. League of Nations died because World War II happened, right? It's supposed to prevent another war, it failed. So until today, there's no big World War III, means the United Nations is still doing its job. So what you need to know is that the United Nations is a replacement for the League of Nations. And League of Nations died. And many of you, you either concentrated so much on the League of Nations, alright, or you concentrated so much on the United Nations. Okay, but you have to understand, this entire cartoon is about the Korean conflict. Where does it say Korean conflict? Where? History doesn't repeat itself? No. That doesn't tell you about Korean War. Thank you. Jared, say louder. Shh. Jared, say louder. The date. The date is very important because why? It's 30th of June 1950. That tells you that this comes up how many days after the North Korean invaded? How many days after the UN sent troops? Oh, sorry. The UN convened a meeting. How many days? See? You don't know. Don't guess. I read how many days? One day. Are you sure? Where are the notes? The notes is here. Alright, it's here. 26th of June. Emergency. See, if you do not know, if you don't know your timeline, that will be very challenging. Now you know, it's 26th of June. The United Nations meet. So you have this source that comes out 4 days. The timestamp for history SBQ are very important. 4 days after the UN met, 5 days after North Korea invaded the South, this cartoon came out. That's a very important clue. There's another very important clue, you're right. History doesn't repeat itself. Okay, so there are many things you need to circle, many parts. Now you need to tie up everything together. So what is the cartoonist trying to say? Question, what is the message of the cartoon? Explain your answer using details and your knowledge. History always got this thing, and your knowledge. Your knowledge of when the invasion happened. SS don't have this time. Question phrasing. Interesting. Okay, so few things. Question type is inference. No need to cross-refer. No need to state the purpose. No need. If you want, can, but actually no need. Many students are only able to identify the sub-message. Okay. What is sub-message? Sub-message, you tell me. President Truman is very determined. Very determined. That is a sub-message. Why? Because when you talk about President Truman, very determined, you're talking about Truman. You're not talking about the UN. You're not talking about League of Nations. You're not talking about the Korean War. You're not talking about history repeat itself. Students that get full marks for this are able to tie up everything, all the sub-messages, to give a big message about the Korean War. So what do you think the message is? Don't look at the answer. The answer is there, I know. What is the message? Some students only concentrate on the weaknesses of the League of Nations. This message is to show that League of Nations is not successful. It is very weak. It's been replaced by the UN. Again, the problem with that, you're not paying attention to Truman and the UN holding hands going into the conflict. So the best answer are answers able to tie in. And I told one class, I can't remember which class, is that it is not a positive message. It's actually very negative. It's very negative at the Korean War. Why? Okay, let me explain to you. Do we learn or do we not learn from our mistakes in the past? We learn, right? So if we slap ourselves on the right cheek, we feel pain where? And the next time, will we slap ourselves on the right cheek?
No.
That is normal people, right? Okay, only Janani will slap ourselves on the left cheek, but the rest of us won't even slap ourselves. That is normal, right? What I mean to say is that if you experience a bad past, you will try to prevent that past from happening again. So you do something totally different. Correct? Am I correct to say that? So that is the reason why the cartoonist say history doesn't repeat itself. Past things will not repeat itself. And one of the things that the US doesn't want to get repeated is they don't want to condemn the League of Nations to inaction. They want to help the League of Nations. They want to help the League of Nations to fight against aggression. They wanted to do that. But in so doing, in helping the UN fight aggression, what do you think is right, Michelle?
Trying to destroy UN? They're too aggressive.
They are too aggressive. They are too in a rush. Right? They are going headlong without thinking. To the cartoonist, right? What Truman and the UN is doing, you see, straight away, the UN picks up a what? And this signifies what?
Violence.
Military action. There are many ways to prevent North Korea. There are many ways to punish North Korea. One is by diplomacy, right? You can isolate. One is to have economic blockade. There are so many ways. So to the cartoonist, why straight away consider military action? I know why. You want to prevent the mistake of the past. But in so doing, you are going to make a terrible mistake. By thinking first of military outcome. You understand? The cartoonist is trying to say. Nobody in this class gets that correct. It is difficult, yeah. Okay, but never mind. I just want to show you that for history electives, the cartoons are always a challenging one. Spend some time thinking about it. All the O-level cartoons are not easy. Because the sub-messages are easy, but the main message, right, is a bit challenging. You must know your topic very well. You must know the Korean conflict is about what. And this cartoonist, although he's British cartoonist, but he is against UN and US going to the Korean conflict in a big rush and using military as a solution. Just because they don't want to repeat the mistake of the past. To him, that's not a good excuse. People should slow down a bit. This is only 4 days. And he's very worried that this conflict will be longer than what everybody assumes it will be. Is it true? Did the conflict last very long? Yes, the conflict hasn't finished yet. This is a 60-year-old conflict. Until today, I keep on telling the class, the Korean conflict hasn't been over. Until today, the US is still in a war state. 55,000 American servicemen are in South Korea defending from the North at the 38th parallel. And God knows how many 100,000 of North Korean soldiers are at the border as well. Right? And once in a while, nuclear rockets start flying and things like that, and it becomes very complicated. Alright, so take note. So the answer is, these are from the examiner report. Every time after O-level, examiner often tell the teachers that, hey, look, okay, candidates needed to tended to concentrate on the weakness of failing or the League of Nations rather than the intended message about UN. So many people concentrate only on League of Nations. Those who pick up the message regarding the UN and the US rarely made the link in the Korean War. This is what many of you may say. You lose up 1 mark or 2 marks in the final part. Good answers combine all the sub-messages. How many sub-messages? UN, USA, Korea, League of Nations. History doesn't repeat. So I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 things must be tied up in your answer. Not easy, huh? I tell you now, not easy. Okay, but with practice, we'll get there. Just giving you an idea. This is the expectation required in the O-levels. Okay. Look at my answer. I wrote this. All the bold are important things. Can you see the various sub-messages? Can you see the various sub-messages in my answer? As you go along, please read. Everyone read on your own. Oh, my mistake. This should be L-O-N. Thanks, Roshan. Sorry. Death of the L-O-N here. My mistake. Okay, thanks, Jianping, for pointing out. Okay, death of the League of Nations. Okay, are we good? Okay, now, read your own answer. Read. Take out your answers. Read your own. Hurry up. See what you have thought of. Read your own answer, what you have written.